Conducting quality assurance and quality control lab tests ensure the materials and processes used in airport pavements meet specific standards and specifications. For FAA projects, they must be conducted in an accredited lab meeting ASTM D3666. Let's look at some common QA/QC lab tests and the tools used to conduct them, such as Marshall hammers and gyratory compactors. These tools prepare specimens for a suite of mechanical and volumetric tests, including stability and density measurements. ASTM D2041 determines the theoretical maximum specific gravity and density of uncompacted asphalt mixtures, crucial for laboratory air voids and field compaction determinations. The process involves breaking up the mixture, weighing a sample, placing it in a vacuum flask or bowl filled with water, and applying agitation and vacuum to remove all air. The sample is then weighed again to calculate volume and theoretical maximum specific gravity, also known as rice density. The ASTM D2726 test method measures the bulk density of a sample to calculate air voids and verify the job mix formula. The sample is weighed underwater, and then weighed again in air at saturated surface dried condition. The differences in these weights determine bulk density. ASTM D6307 measures asphalt binder content using the ignition method. The binder is burned off in a furnace between 482 and 540 degrees Celsius until the sample weight changes by no more than 0.01%. The remaining aggregate is used for gradation analysis. ASTM D2172 outlines solvent-based methods for extracting asphalt binder. The most popular approach involves a centrifuge to separate the binder from the aggregate by spinning the sample at high speeds. This provides an accurate measurement of the binder content in the asphalt mixture. ASTM D5444 determines the extracted gradation of aggregates in an asphalt mixture after the asphalt binder is removed. The sample is washed to remove dust, fines, or any residual binder coating the aggregates. It then passes through a series of sieves, and the amount retained on each sieve is weighed to calculate the particle size distribution. During construction, contractors use control charts to monitor material quality and adjust processes to meet standards. For instance, a chart showing asphalt content from the ignition oven test might indicate variability if a lot falls outside specification limits, prompting further analysis. Quality assurance and control testing ensure airfield pavements meet the highest durability and performance standards.